Awatahama, Shikoku. A small village on the smallest of the four main islands of Japan. It was here that the master and his followers first met and laid down the foundation of this dynamic new style of karate. It is here they still meet on occasion, never failing to visit a small restaurant where they can share a good meal and some memories of their early struggles. Noriyoshi Nakamoto, chief instructor, lives at a training club on the beach of Awatahama. It is the place where the potential of both he and Ashihara Karate were discovered. His duties now include providing leadership for members of this club. Joko Ninomiya is the head instructor of the Ashihara headquarters in Denver, Colorado, in the U.S. Having gained recognition in Japan as the all-Japan champion, his next challenge is to introduce Ashihara Karate to the world. This demonstration of the power of Ninomiya's kicks from a distance of only 50 centimeters illustrates his superb skill. Having returned to Japan, his home after a long absence, he feels the eyes of his students watching his every move and knows that he, as their model, must strive to do his utmost. Master Ashihara, why did you choose this particular location to train?
Open spaces or enclosed areas. One must learn to defend himself under all circumstances. This time, we're working under outdoor conditions. Karate should not be limited to the wooden floors of the dojo.
I see.
We're working to make karate a part of our everyday lives. Ashihara Karate has been developed for both group practice and for individual practice. It's designed for the practitioner who can devote every minute of every day to training and for the practitioner with limited time. Ashihara Karate is for everybody.
Ashihara Karate Headquarters, Mecca to young karate enthusiasts from all over the country. In his drive to develop new skills and techniques, which he can share with his fellow instructors and students, Hideyuki Ashihara isolates himself and directs all of his energy toward achieving the answer.
Actually, the key to the roundhouse block is proper wrist work, like this, and pow. A kick does not follow the block as a separate action. No, blocking is carried out with the intention of executing a kick. The first rule is to return the hips to a ready position as quickly as possible.
Long-distance sabaki, as in short and middle-distance sabaki, relies heavily on footwork. The opponent's attack can be avoided by stepping back. By using combinations of insteps, side steps, cross steps, linked with back steps, counterattacks can be mounted.
I'll go over long distance combinations. If the distance to be covered is long, you can dodge your opponent's kick by stepping back instead of blocking it with your hand or foot. Or you may kick from a position to his side by moving your front leg in response to his kick. Also, to counter a roundhouse kick, dodge and move in to counter as soon as his kicking leg lands. In defending against a roundhouse kick from the left, where there is a great deal of distance between you and your opponent, judge the distance and kick. The distance can be reduced once you grasp the opponent's timing. Let's try again. Try to kick through your target.